Hello everyone and welcome back to Contra Health Scam. So today we're going to talk about supplements that are made using the concept of nanoscience and nanotechnology. Are these supplements really the real deal? Are they actually potent supplements that can help you, you know, in your health and give you the best results? Well, in this video we're going to talk about all these things and we're going to use one particular example. In this video I'm going to review a nanoscience supplement that someone asked me to look into, and after that then we're going to look at some of the articles that I pulled up concerning nanoscience and nanotechnology, the industry in general, and all the information you need to know and to help you to decide on whether to spend your money buying these supplements or keeping your distance from them. All right, so let's begin. Alright, so here is the website of the supplement I was asked to review, and this is the name of the supplement. The name is actually Nanosoma, but the chemical name is Metadichol or Metadichol. I don't know how they pronounce it. But anyway, so this so-called supplement that has a patent is actually a patented supplement. According to the person who is behind it, said it's a nano emulsion of long chain alcohols found in many foods. It's commonly called polycosanol and it's present in foods such as rice, sugarcane, wheat, and peanuts. Okay, so it claims that this supplement acts on nuclear vitamin D receptors, which is even patented, that are presented in cells throughout the body to stimulate the immune system and inhibit a variety of disease processes. So as you can see here, it says nature meets nanoscience, plant-based nano emulsion to strengthen immunity and repair the skin. So this is the claim concerning this particular Metadichol, but this is not just one of the claims. Going down to the website, you will see that there are even more claims here. According to the people behind this supplement, Nanosoma also rejuvenates the skin, improves energy level, enhances wound healing, assists cardiovascular health, modulates the immune system, reduces inflammation and pain, improves longevity and reverses aging, serves as a natural vitamin D substitute, repairs damaged blood vessels and scar tissues. And this is not all, believe me. So according to the manufacturers of this nano supplement, this Metadichol has a spiritual connection in that the ingredients that they used manufacturing these supplements were taken from this pond in India called Viteswaran. I don't know whether I pronounce this correctly, but Viteswaran. So according to them, there is no bacteria in this pond, okay, because the natural Nanosoma, that is natural Metadichol, is found in this lake. So according to them, this pond, there's no bacteria growing in it that has been tested. According to them, the reason why there's no bacteria in this particular pond is that a ritual at the temple involves blessing jaggery, which is a kind of raw sugar, and throwing it in the pond. So this sugar contains the constituents of Nanosoma. According to them, devotees worship jaggery and mess it in the temple pond that is believed to cure 4,448 diseases. So you can see the so-called spiritual connection and the superstitious background of this Nanosoma or nano supplement. So it continues and there are more claims here, and going towards the other sections of the website, they even provided so-called science and the discovery and the stuff. We're not going to look into it, but instead we're going to look at the publications that they said they have. And here, let's look at these studies first. All these studies, you can see a lot of claims. Journal of Stem Cell Research and Therapy, Biology and Medicine, Journal of Cytokine Biology, Journal of Cancer Science of Therapy, Journal of Aging Science, Journal of Cancer Science, etc, etc. So all these things are claims of what this Metadichol can do. It can cure all manner of diseases, ranging from infectious diseases to even cancer and even anti-aging, etc, etc. Okay, and then speaking about publications, this, believe it or not, this supplement has a lot of publications and with a lot of claims also. And one thing I found out is that all the publications are coming from just one source, and the source is the owner of the company behind this supplement. And looking at some of the examples here, this is the guy that is behind the supplement. So his name is P.R. Raghavan. Okay, he's based in USA, New York. So he's the owner of this supplement. And as you can see, he's the one publishing all these things. So here he's talking about how his supplement tackles infectious diseases. And then right here too, he was saying that his Metadichol is a nanolipid emulsion that can treat diabetes. And he's the same guy, look at his name again, he's the one that published this. Alright, moving to another study. Here, he's talking about how his Metadichol is going to help you in treating infections. And he's the same guy that published this article. This study. Next, he's talking again about how his Metadichol is a vitamin D receptor inverse agonist, like a vitamin D substitute. He's the same guy that is writing this study. Next, this one also is a claim that he made that was covered in a news article that is saying that Metadichol could reverse age-related diseases. Okay, he was quoted as the one who was making the claim here. Okay, look at it here. As a long-term user of Metadichol for over 5 years, I've seen 24% decrease in my biological age based on measurement of the telomere's length, said Dr. P.R. Raghavan, chairman and CEO of NanoRx. So he's the same guy that is making all these claims. So all these claims are coming from one source. Next, he said again, Metadichol offers important breakthrough and hope in the treatment of tuberculosis. Okay, and he is the same person that is writing this. Alright, so he's the one who is claiming the whole thing according to this article here. So the founder of NanoRx Inc., Dr. P.R. Raghavan, will present the research results in an upcoming international conference on infectious diseases, etc. So what you need to take away from this is that all the scientific studies concerning this particular Metadichol is coming from the person who is manufacturing it. So there are no third-party sources confirming the actual effectiveness of this supplement. Okay, and given the fact that he's basing the supplement on some religious superstition that some lake has been found to cure 4,448 diseases, so he's going there to take out his, his supplement, and then now he's claiming that his supplement cures all manner of diseases, ranging from infectious diseases to cancer, to tuberculosis, and even to anti-aging too. So you can see that there's a problem with this particular supplement. All right, so if you ask me, should you waste your money? Because the pricing is not even cheap. So if you want to buy it, it will relieve your wallet of at least 180 Australian dollars. Okay, so this is not a cheap product whatsoever. And given what you've already uncovered about it, in that it's mostly based on superstition, and all the scientific studies that were supposedly done about it is coming from just the manufacturer himself, and there's no single third-party research that is confirming whatever he's claiming, it just shows you that we're dealing with a product that will most likely never work. Talking about the guy who even manufactured this supplement, we're going to look at who he is actually. So according to his biography, P.R. Raghavan is the CEO of NanoRx Inc. and has a PhD in organic chemistry from Oregon State University. He also did its master's in chemistry from IIT Mumbai, India. And looking at his qualifications, I have a problem with it, because this is someone who has a PhD in organic chemistry. And me being a medical professional, when we did organic chemistry in a medical school, it was like a passing course that we did in our first year. So it's not something, it's not like a major course in medicine. So him now coming out and bringing out all these scientific studies that look like medical trials, it's kind of very, shady if you ask me. So I wouldn't trust whatever this guy is selling, okay? Speaking about nanoscience and nanotechnology itself, we're going to now, segue into what is this about this industry and should we trust it when it comes to manufacturing medical supplements that we can use, and all those claims about nanotechnology. Do they even have any place in medicine? All right, so this is a question a lot of people have asked, and during my research, I found out that we have a problem with this industry as a whole, okay? And I have some articles I pulled up concerning it. I'm going to look into them briefly, starting with this one that was written back in 2010, August 2010. You can see the name here, the title here, Nano Nonsense, 25 Years of Charlatanry by Scott Loughlin. So he wrote this back in 2010. Okay, and now look at what he wrote. I used to work next to the Center for Nanotechnology. The first indication I had that there was something wrong with the discipline of nanotechnology is I noticed that people who worked there were the same people who used to do chemistry and material science. It appeared to be a more fashionable label for these subjects. Really, material science was sort of fancy label for the chemistry of things we use to build other things. Okay, new name for chemists. Later on, I actually read Drexler's PhD thesis, which invented the subject. I can sum it up thusly. Behold the Schrödinger equation, this equation. With this mighty equation, we may go forth and invent an entirely new form of chemistry with which we may create new and superior forms of life, which are mechanical in their form rather than squishily inefficient biological looking things. We shall use the mighty powers of the computer to do these things. They shall bring forth many great marvels, and then the heavenly, you know, sky something, and then heavenly music. That's it. That's what the whole book is. Oh yes, there were a few collections of intimidating tables and graphs purporting to indicate that such a thing might be possible, and Drexler does sketch out some impressive looking mechanical designs of which he supposes a nanobot might look like. But without more than passing justification, he seems to lack the imagination, of course, the physics to figure out what a real nano-sized doodad might look like. So the summary of this particular article is that this guy used to work, you know, in a nanotechnology establishment. So one day he decided, okay, let me read the thesis that actually began this industry, you know, this nanotechnology industry as a whole. And he found out that it was just, you know, a bit of a scientific brouhaha that doesn't make any sense. Someone who was like, you know, predicting the future. And this is what the whole industry of nanotechnology is based on. It's like an industry based on science fiction. So that's exactly what this article is talking and complaining about. August 2010, so this was like 25 years after the industry started. So that as at 2010, the industry was already 25 years old. So at that point, you know, people have already started asking questions. So this is the basics of this article. I'll leave it in the description below for you to read and, you know, to be informed about it. And that's not just the article I pulled up concerning this stuff, okay? There was someone who was working in this nano industry, and he got so pissed off that he created an entire website dedicated to exposing the lies, so-called lies, associated with this industry. And this is what we're going to look at now. So it's called Nano-Censored. Of course, you can see what is written there. So the next big thing is also a really small censored, or you know, small is like it's a really censored. But looking at the situation here, this website is no longer being maintained because the owner died in 2010. So regardless, the point is that there are people who are exposing this industry as fraudulent and scammy in itself. There's nothing good that will ever come out from this nanoscience and technology. Everybody in this industry just hoping that one day things will work out, and it's based on complete science fiction, you know, that it's not real. And this is the kind of situation I'm finding with nanoscience and nanotechnology, even though it's still getting massive funding from the government, of course, because they want to stay a step ahead of the other when it comes to innovations and new technology. So that one is understandable, but the industry itself has a big question around it. The technology hasn't matured yet. There's no single benefit anyone has, you know, has gotten from nanoscience and nanotechnology, especially when it comes to the medical industry. Because believe me, I attend medical conferences and I've never heard of anybody presenting articles saying that nanotechnology has brought this particular, you know, this new innovation that we can use to treat patients. Now we are here at the National Institute of Health website, and they are talking about nano nonsense, which means the science, you know, the concept of nanoscience and nanotechnology is questionable. I will leave this article also in the description box so that you can read about it. And then finally, let's talk about this Time article that was written in 2015, where they are saying, here is why nobody is talking about nanotech anymore. Okay, So of all the investment fads and manias over the past few decades, none have been as big of a fizzle as the craze for nanotech stocks. 10 years ago, venture capitalists were scrambling for investments. Startups with nano in their names flourished, and even a few nanotech funds launched hoping to track a rising industry. And today, nobody in the stock market gets excited about the phrase nanotech anymore, which is strange because nanotechnology itself, that is the science and engineering conducted on a molecular scale measuring less than 100 nanometers, is yielding applications and products in a number of industries, just as its more sensible supporters have long predicted. Okay, so they talk about the history of the nanotech craze that happened back in 2005, but then with time everybody decided to jump ship, and now nobody's talking about nanotech anymore. People who used to invest in nanotech industries have actually changed their names and removing nano from their names because no one is actually investing into their companies anymore because no one is seeing any results or any applicability of whatever they are peddling. But there's still a lot of massive funding in the industry, and you know, believe me, if you ask me of my final opinion, I will say that for now, nanotechnology is a useless industry as far as when it comes to health and wellness. So any supplements that is connected to nanoscience and nanotechnology, I would advise you to not waste your money buying them, because believe me, there's no point even wasting your money when the industry itself is problematic and no one is seeing any results coming from the industry that can be applicable to life. Everything about this industry is all about hype, and there is no substance, at least for now. And we're talking about almost 3 decades later, and we're still not seeing any applicability of whatever they are putting out. All right, so please, this is my opinion concerning this issue, and I hope it has helped you making your decision. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this video has been helpful for you. Please consider liking, sharing, subscribing to this channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.